Welcome to another episode of 9/11 was an inside job and state crimes against democracy. Today we're going to be concentrating on the state crimes against democracy. We have a particularly good learning example this week. Remember the Officer Dorner of the LAPD who went berserk after he got fired? It's an interesting study because in the episodes like some of those mass shootings that we've had lately, where there's supposed to be one lone gunman going nuts and killing 20 people, turns out that you can identify what's a false flag operation, what's a covert op, very easily in our system now. And this Dorner thing really illustrates that. I'll illustrate what I'm talking about. In all of those mass shootings that they've had lately, they've had an agenda ready to go, and that's the gun control agenda. And they immediately, all of the news sources immediately, at the very beginning, have an explanation for who did it, and they all stick to that script. Now, there are some subtle variations, of course, as legitimate news people try to report what they see, but, you know, they only get to report it once, and then the spin doctors move in and stifle it. Well, the difference is, like this Dorner thing, he's apparently an officer who identified pretty much with the elite. After all, the officers are particularly used to enforce the interests of the elite and against the general population of the country. So this fellow felt particularly upset when he was cast out of the group that he thought he belonged to. He went on a shooting spree, and it was totally it was unexpected. They didn't have a clue what was happening. And you notice that for the entire last week, here's the difference. Something that's not a false flag op is characterized by different reports from every different angle. But we have something in this country that's completely horrible, and it's been around as long as I can remember. And I don't know if the FBI wrote it, but they got the nickname the Federal Bureau of Incineration. Way back when in Philadelphia, there was a group called the MOVE, M-O-V-E, and the entire block was burned down. And of course, we're all familiar with Waco. Waco's another example where the government murdered people trying to get out. They shot them. The people trying to escape Waco were shot down while the tanks created a fire at Waco. Now, you'll still hear spin saying that, oh no, that was the Branch Davidians set that fire themselves. And that's just a downright lie. So here we go. Now, this time with Dorner, Alex Jones, who you may regard as a nutcase or not, it doesn't matter. A lot of the times he nails it right on the head. Whether you like him or not, that's too bad. But the fact is, he nails it. And on this one, he called it before it happened. When he realized that the police had asked CNN to halt its feed from the helicopter that was over the building before it was burning. And Alex Jones said, what are they getting ready for? A Waco-style ending? And he said that it's time-stamped on YouTube, 2.5 hours before the fire started. And of course, there's a recording of the police saying, we've shot in 7 burners and the place is on fire and the answer is good. And that's horrible. I mean, it's amazing that tape exists. Now, what it is they claim that they shot in a bunch of, tear gas that was the type that would never cause a fire. And he didn't come out with that. So they said, well, maybe we send in the type that causes a fire, he'll come out. And they shot in these ones that are known for causing fires, and of course it did. And you'd have a real hard time proving that it wasn't intentional, because that seems to be the standard ending. My opinion is that all this money spent on high-tech nonsense, spend it on the salaries of people just waiting them out. Surround the place and just wait them out. It takes 10 weeks, 2 months, whatever it takes to wait him out. Nobody gets killed unless the guy takes his own life, and you certainly don't have to burn down the area. Well, I'm going to go ahead and play this Alex Jones clip, and you know, he pretty much says it for what it is. We'll come back in the middle while I edit out the commercials that we're not allowed to have on cable access. So anyway, here we go. We're going to change right over.
A lot of these video and audio clips we're going to be playing speak for themselves. 2 hours before Chris Dorner reportedly got burned up inside of that cabin after killing another sheriff's deputy in Big Bear outside Los Angeles up in the mountains. And then on top of it, well, I guess the San Bernardino Sheriff's Department, on top of it, you know, also seeing the SWAT team surround it and all the rest of this, I shot a video 2 hours before saying that I expect to see it go up in flames. We're going to play that clip coming up. People are like, how on earth did you know this? Well, the standard procedure with someone held up in a house with a firearm that's already killed police or government gods is to use an armored vehicle or tank to knock down the walls and then set the place on fire. That's what they did at Waco. And that's why Waco was so evil, because David Koresh could have been picked up in town at any time. He went into town every day. They had an auto repair shop a couple miles away. He went into town to the grocery store. He jogged outside the Branch Davidian Ranch that they called a compound to dehumanize him. And they went to have a PR stunt with the ATF to shoot the place up. The Davidians fought back. So then they had the military come in and engage in a siege and burn the place down, shoot people trying to get out, and blew up the little newborn babies and people, and then posed with their skulls later. These were not warriors. These were psychopathic demons. And you see the LAPD not even apologizing for shooting up vehicles that didn't even match the description. You see just the insanity of the government cult. And it is a government cult. These people in these corrupt police departments think they're rock stars, and the government bureaucrats above them think they're royalty. Anybody who's worked around them has seen it for themselves. And America is going the same way as any other corrupt empire. Now, that said, Dorner, I thought from the beginning this was a real story, just because it looks like a real story. It acts like one. The government's all disjointed and badly coordinated and engaged in PR disasters. When you see real staged events, the script is written minute one, and it all rolls out. And they have their targeted liberty that they're trying to take, or the power they're trying to seize. Christopher Dorner went out Waco style. And I know the establishment is not happy, because there wasn't 28 children, 17 of them under the age of 10, many of them newborn babies or toddlers. This wasn't a real trophy event where they could pose with the dead children's skulls and their dead bodies to show off what tough guys they are. Like when you watch Waco, the Rules of Engagement, it shows DOD snipers and ATF and FBI snipers standing around bragging about how they're honed to kill, and just incredibly manly to have the tanks knock down the walls and shoot Davidians as they tried to get out, and then put a anti-personnel, a shape charge mine on top of the church records vault and kill everybody inside. In fact, the only thing more manly was the LAPD, big fans of what they did, shooting up a truck, a different make and model and brand and color. Dorner's driving a silver pickup. Well, if you see a blue pickup doing a paper route with two women, that's obviously Dorner. You know, different color women, a woman in the back throwing papers out, open fire. You know, shoot them up, shoot them both. You know, you pull a white guy over in a car, tell him go ahead and leave, and then ram him 10 seconds later and shoot his vehicle up. Good. Good. In fact, I think they ought to just have gunships fly in, AC-130s with Gatling guns, but also A-10 Warthogs, and just fly up and down the major Los Angeles and Southern California roads and just open fire like it was the highway of death outside of Kuwait going into Iraq, and just take them out. Because that would be like a sacrifice. That's why government always demands human sacrifice once it gets powerful enough, is that the public needs to be taught, you are the food. You are the food. You are here to be eaten for dinner. And I think it's absolutely wonderful. And I think it's wonderful what happened last night. It's how I was able to predict 2 hours before. I said, I think they're going to burn him down Waco style. And we're going to play a clip of that where I predicted it and uploaded it, timestamped to YouTube, timestamped to Infowars.com, because it's standard procedure to go in with a tank and ram it and then tell the media cut the feed just like Waco, and they'll dutifully do it. And Wolf Blitzer says this is unprecedented. No, it's not. They cut the feed. I shot a video 1 minute after and uploaded it called Chris Dorner Torched Waco Style. Break down the fact that, in fact, that's the video I shot actually after I was confirmed right. If you actually go to Infowars.com, there's another article there, and you can go to our YouTube page, and I break it all down, and I'll give you the actual name of that video here in just a moment. Yes, it's Chris Dorner, CNN cuts live feed. Alex Jones predicts they will burn him Waco style. That is the actual name of a video that I put out roughly 2 hours before the torching. You see the videos I shot. Chris Dorner cornered, CNN cuts live feed. I predict they'll torch him. Then checkpoints paralyze Big Bear. And then after it happened, well, while it was starting to burn, Chris Dorner torched Waco style. And it was not hard to know the standard default infantry training that SWAT teams, and they are domestic military groups, it's against the law, against the Constitution, Bill of Rights, but it doesn't matter, because a military fights an enemy. And so that's why the public is now seen as the enemy by more and more of these departments and paramilitary groups. And I understand the need for special teams sometimes, but they're using them for checkpoints on the highways now. They've got military drills all over the country, and they're now admitting, oh, we are acclimating you, and we're working with the local police department with role players screaming, I'm not turning my guns in, and saying, I need food. See, they're preparing for a collapse and a war with the American people in the reorganization of the country. So I was being a little bit sarcastic there, saying, this is all wonderful. This is actually horrible. And see, I don't hate the police out of hand. They're just brainwashed Americans like everybody else. And when I see these really corrupt, out of control, fear-driven, running off the edge of a cliff from their own shadow, it really freaks me out. It freaks me out that they're shooting up cars and running checkpoints and beating people up. And I watched live feeds from helicopters as they had traffic backed up 20 miles up in the mountains by Big Bear. And they would actually aim guns at families in their cars and go through their cars when they knew Dorner was surrounded and they pinned him in the house. It was just all a big excuse to power grab. I mean, I've seen cases now where there'll be a bank robbery and they'll shut down major highways and then just have guns aimed at people as they drive up. And again, it's this attitude of, we're going to march your kids out of the school in a drill. We're going to put our hands on you with the TSA. We're going to set up warrantless checkpoints. I mean, this is America becoming North Korea. And obviously, I am pretty freaked out right now by the fact that they did another Waco-style event. And they didn't know if he had hostages in there. I mean, if they would have had 17 little children under the age of 10, would they have barbecued them? And then said that Dorner said it? Now, here's the deal. This just shows the lying culture now out in the open, out in everyone's face. We're going to play some of the clips, the news clip and the scanner clip here in a moment, then get into Obama's State of the Union. But imagine how obvious it is when they say they're asking the media to cut the live feeds as they're surrounding it and have armored wheeled tanks pulling up, about to do an infantry maneuver, standard military maneuver. Knock down the walls when you've got infantry inside and they don't have anti-tank weapons, and then firebomb it. I mean, it's 101, or bring a helicopter in like Randy Weaver with a big bucket of gasoline that they can remote control and drop on top of the house. But media didn't follow orders and caught it on video, so they backed off because media was going into the woods and covering it. Because it's like a big turkey shoot. Hey, we got women and kids in here. Let's shoot mama with a baby in her arms. Let's shoot a little kid in the back. And because to these guys, Because these aren't real men. These aren't soldiers. These are people that it's like hunting. These are arrested development wimps. I've studied their MO, these types, who just enjoy killing people, but from a distance in a controlled way, like Lon Horiuchi, the sniper, where they feel powerful. And you see the culture of the drones and all of this, and it totally dehumanizes everyone. And on the other side of it, you've got the public running around saying, kill the cops, kill more, great job, Dorner, Team Dorner, and all this garbage. Somebody ought to make an image of Obama in a jersey that has a zero on it and says Team Dorner, because he's anti-gun, anti the citizens owning guns, pro-government, a total statist who was mad that he was thrown out of the cult and was going to show the cult to the feds, hey, I'm going to give you trouble in a PR disaster. I'm going to throw a big giant temper tantrum. I'm going to go shoot a police captain's daughter. And people are defending that. So the police are turning into demons. The public's turning into demons. America accepts torture, abortion, secret arrest, warrantless wiretapping, injustice. And now all the prosperity is going out the window. All the liberty is going out the window. Now, our story, we broke this yesterday as it was happening, that clearly they cut the power. They knew that place. They talked to the owner. They knew that that house did not, that cabin did not have cable in it. They knew they could cut the power with the power lines, and it turns out they had cut the power. Okay? They simply wanted to burn that thing down. Same thing at Waco. They told the media, okay, you've been a mile away, get back 3 miles. So they had to have telephoto. Powerful enough is that the public needs to be taught, you are the food. You are the food. You are here to be eaten for dinner. And I think it's absolutely wonderful. And I think it's wonderful what happened last night. It's how I was able to predict 2 hours before. I said, I think they're going to burn him down Waco style. And we're going to play a clip of that where I predicted it and uploaded it. State of the Union. But imagine how obvious it is. Came from, then it was later confirmed to be the real FLIR, and it's infantry behind the armored vehicles, going into the building behind it, shooting the people, setting the fires, everything. And it later came out in Congress, Delta Force said, quote, we were ordered to go in and pull triggers. So now we have the new clips from the news with San Bernardino on the open scanners saying, burn that mother effer down, burn it down. We're going to play that clip in a moment. And then we have the actual scanner of the tank inside planting the firebombs. Planting the firebombs. And they say, okay, we planted them, we planted the burners, now the fire's lit. Okay, good job. They're so arrogant now, they cut the feed, burn it down in front of you, and then tell you they didn't burn it down, and you watch, they're going to say Dorner burned it down. Dorner burned it down. I mean, how many times do SWAT teams shoot their own officers and then frame the person's house they've come in? It's a culture of they come first, they're a gang, and you're nobody. Now, not all departments have succumbed to this, but the big cities mainly have, and it's despicable. And we know the threat to the public on the helicopters. I've got reports where they, quote, ordered the local news, but some of the local news didn't follow orders. You see, oh, we better get rid of that First Amendment. And still carried the audio. And the local news, and I've got the reports right here, said, hey, it's audio of the scanners. How do we know he doesn't have a scanner? No, we're going to run this. And see, they've scrambled most of the scanners. In the last few years, it's gone to this federal system, and they've unified the codes. But still, there's a lot of cops out there who were kind of having a, you know, a big pity party, hysteria party, who were so uncontrolled, you know, they're shooting up cars the wrong color. Can you imagine? Oh, there's a white guy in a silver car. Let's shoot that up. There's some women throwing newspapers out of a blue truck. Looks nothing like Dorner's truck that's silver. Let's just shoot them up. I mean, that's Yosemite Sam level. Just running around. And this is the government that's got the helicopters, the checkpoints, the guns, the weapons, the surveillance. It's why the founders said, keep that government small, keep it under control, because government's like fire. It is a dangerous servant and a fearful master. And that's the terrorist, of course, George Washington, that FEMA demonizes all day. And I know police, I've heard them all over talk radio and in the news, all over the country, they're marveling at how unprofessional the LAPD is. But it's beyond that. It's a bunch of crazy people. I'm not saying they're all crazy, but, I mean, just bad leadership, unaccountable, and then they talk on the scanners, okay, you've broken through, put the burners down and burn them up like we planned, okay, the burners are ignited, the house is on fire. I mean, open and shut. And you've got the cops outside running around screaming in front of news, burn him, kill him, just like totally turned over to rage. Because it's a cult. It's like crying for Kim Jong-il when he died, all the fake days of crying. The more they show off and cry for the dead officer they just killed, he just reportedly shot. And I get it. You know, guy died. It's what you signed on for. I'm sad you're dead. Get a great pension for your family. You know, have a nice parade. You signed on to be a tough guy, okay? Okay, you signed on to do this. Quite frankly, sounds pretty exciting to me. I mean, you signed on for all this, and people are going to die. I mean, that's what you signed on for. And I'm sad the cop's dead, but what about the citizens that are getting shot up? And so the police are freaking out, screaming, burn that mother effer! You know, we played the clip earlier. We'll play it again. But when we come back...
Oh, he's just about to launch into a commercial, so I'm going to jump ahead. I'm sorry I broke it up a little bit in the middle there. It's just absolutely amazing. But I don't think Alex Jones is that sensational. He seems to really tell it like it is, don't you think? I really think in this case, his sensationalism is warranted. I mean, after all, they didn't just give that nomer to the FBI, you know, Federal Bureau of Incineration. That isn't for no reason at all. This was the LAPD, make no mistake about it. It wasn't the FBI again, but it's like they read from the same playbook. All right, well, we're going to go ahead and let her rip.
All the MO looks like this was a real story, a real event. From the paramilitary police force that we've created in this country, it's going to bite itself in the butt. Militaries have always killed each other. There's always been friendly fire. There's always been fragging. This stuff goes on, especially as a lot of people get into these positions to go out and be able to kill people. You know, they're getting into it to go out and kill people, where they can legally and lawfully kill people as psychopaths. And I'd say 20% of cops are that type of person now. And they've absolutely got to be removed, but instead they're being put in positions of power. But I want to get your take on Obama's State of the Union that I haven't gotten to yet. I'll play some clips in a moment, and I want to get your take on what you saw yesterday. But we've got a couple clips we're going to play now. Let's just get to the KCAL clip we've already played, then I'll get to the other clips I haven't played yet. This is a 51-second clip on the local TV station where they've got feeds from the ground with police running around screaming, burn that house down, bleep, burn that mother bleep down. And then we have the audio inside the tank back to the command post on the scanner on an open radio channel. That's how dumb they think you are. They're going to do something illegal. They're going to purposely burn this guy up so they don't have to get killed, taking him, you know, going in and taking him out or trying to get him to surrender. They just want to get this over with. Okay, and clearly he was never going to surrender, so I can see the psychology of that. But still, the media is compliantly turning off the feed so we couldn't see what really happened as the tank knocked down the walls. And conveniently now they're saying, oh, never mind what you heard, just go to sleep. And it's the same on every other big issue where I see on the news, we're going to blow up Building 7 for the other building's safety. Saw it on the news, heard it on the radio, have the clips, cops saying, get back, we're blowing it up. And I go, hey, they said they blew that up. Oh, shut up. You think the government did it? What, do you work for bin Laden? I'm like, no, criminal elements run Al-Qaeda, and they're going to use Al-Qaeda to attack us to take our liberty. Why'd they blow up Building 7? This needs to be investigated. It didn't exist. I'm like, well, I have the video clips. Never mind those children. Never mind. And it's the same thing now. Never mind. Never mind. Never mind that you saw them cut the feed and then you have multiple audio clips of the police saying, we're going to burn him up. And I'm going to get to those right now. Just forget you ever saw that. And forget that DynCorp's been caught running kidnapped children on record, and the UN has over and over again. And, you know, forget the government's been caught shipping narcotics in over and over again. And forget the NSA's warrantlessly wiretapping you. And forget that they're setting up warrantless checkpoints now, searching your vehicles. And forget the fact they're introducing legislation to physically confiscate your guns in multiple states and at the federal level. Just forget it. Forget the fact they're shutting down our power plants and raising our taxes to bankrupt us, to bring us into government receivership. Forget all that. Forget Agenda 21. Everything's fine. The government loves us. They never lie to us. It is this attitude that allows them to cut a feed, torch a building, say they're going to torch it, and then there's no discussion about you just illegally killed somebody. And we're all supposed to just play along with the lie. Okay, so that's when the gunfight was going on. You see fire, you see smoke, not just from firearms. That went out live, and then that was taped live off television, and the media is trying to cover that up. They were clearly trying to set the place on fire then. Okay, and then they wanted to be the heroes and set it on fire and burn him out, but they got driven back. A couple of them got shot. And remember, he's down the hill earlier with the kidnapped couple, and he'd been there for days. How did they know there weren't people inside the building? Now, let's go to the next clip. This is from the armored vehicle, the wheeled tank, that's rammed down three of the walls. It's about to ram down the fourth wall. And they are going to then, quote, place the burners. Wonder what that means. And then, in case they can spin that, oh, well, we don't mean we pull Building 7, or we don't mean, you know, burners mean burners. They go, okay, burners ignited. Okay, the fire is set. Sounds like pretty clear English to me, like the right to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. All right, I'm placing burners. All right, the burners are ignited. Okay, the fire is going. I mean, it's like, hey, honey, will you set a fire on the barbecue pit so I can cook some stuff? Yeah, honey, I'm putting the coals in right now. Okay, I've ignited it. The fire is lit. So let's go ahead and go to that clip right now. Here it is.
All right, Steve, we're gonna go forward with the plan with the burner. Copy. Like we talked about. Seven burners deployed and we have a fire.
Copy, seven burners deployed and we have a fire.
You guys, be ready on the number four side. We have fire in the front. It might come out the back.
All right, they wanted to get to that basement and burn him out. That was the main goal. That was the main push that they were going for. Now, we've got the police running around saying, burn it, burn up the house, clearly trying to burn it up during the first firefight, launching something at it, whether it was the flammable type of tear gas rounds that are somewhat good at starting fires. If you listen later, we don't know what happened. I mean, it almost sounds like they have flamethrowers. I know a lot of the military terminology, at least when I read about World War II, was they would call flamethrowers burners. When they would go in and flamethrow people hiding in holes, they'd go, bring in burners! I've heard the radio transmissions, seen the documentaries, they'd go, you can look this up in the terminology, they'd say, you know, we're 500 yards out with a burner. I mean, that's military terminology. I don't know if it's changed since Korea and Vietnam and World War II, but I mean, it might have been a flamethrower for all we know. I mean, the LAPD's got everything in the world. And by the way, the San Bernardino County and Big Bear, they were, quote, in charge. The sheriff was in charge, but it was the LAPD that was choppered in with the equipment, their vehicles brought in, trucked in on 18-wheelers. They were running the show. Sure, the sheriff was in charge, but he was like, okay, you're the quarterback. Go in there. I almost want to open the phones up for police and get their take on this, but we'll do that after the first round of calls. 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. And we'll get your take on the Dorner situation and the State of the Union. That's the topic. I don't screen your calls, but when I say, hey, I want to hear from you on this, that's what we're talking about. So that's what I want to hear from you on. I really want to hear what you have to say on those subjects. 800-259-9231, and we'll get you up and on the air and We have a guest popping in on the hurricane and the aftermath of that a few months ago. And then now this new winter storm, and just how government isn't responding and is actually raising property taxes on people and stuff. We've got a guest join us for about 15 minutes at the bottom of the next hour, but that's it. The rest of the show is going to be news and open phones today. We've got a lot of other key clips we're going to play from the whole State of the Union last night. But for me, this illustrates the absurdity of all of this. Now, you can go see it time-stamped at YouTube, time-stamped at Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com, about 2 hours before they torched it as they were getting the armored vehicles off the 18-wheelers. I saw that. They said, oh, the police have asked. It's unprecedented for them to cut the feed. We've got a clip of that coming up with Wolf Blitzer. And the other channels did it. Then they started demanding that the scanners be cut. They're like, well, he can't see that. He may have a scanner. And most news did. A few didn't. That's how we had those clips you just heard. I mean, I guess they just think they're God now. They order the media to stand down so they can do whatever. So, and again, this guy, you can say he was bad if he was guilty, and a lot of evidence points that direction. But do you want to be surrounded and have your house burned down and they just say you were a child killer? Corrupt governments will frame people, and our government's been caught framing people. And major crime labs, the LAPD crime lab, the Houston crime lab, the FBI crime lab, the San Francisco crime lab, the Dallas crime lab, almost every crime lab, if you look up the name of your major city, crime lab scandal, you'll see people being framed. I mean, I was exposing police stealing drugs where I grew up in Rockwall, Texas, and they called me in the office and said, we're going to say you stole stereo equipment out of some trailer park. And I said, I'd have never stolen anything but beer out of people's golf carts. The cop's like, look, I know that. You're going to be raped and given AIDS. And he said some other things, racist stuff. And slammed my head down in the thing and said, you know, you're dead if you don't shut up. And then my dad got the word they were going to kill me if we didn't move. We moved to Austin, Texas because of this. I have experienced a cop sitting there going, we know you stole that stereo equipment. We're going to get you for that if you don't shut up about the other trouble you've been causing. And then you're like, I don't stole anything in years. I think I've stole beer out of people's golf carts. Stand up. Stand up right here for me. Slam my head in the thing. Listen, you little. You know, the whole thing was spit dripping out of his mouth. So I have experienced it. And I was just like, stop pulling us over and trying to search for drugs when we're a bunch of, you know, crap-kicking jock, you know, cowboy hat-wearing beer drinkers. Stop saying we're doing drugs when you're the one selling them. Anyways, I'm already digressing. The public is so naive, ladies and gentlemen. The public is so absolutely naive. They have no idea what's really going on in this country. And that's why we're being absolutely robbed. And now some people are awake, but their answer is just kill all the police. We've seen that all over the news. Like, the news is like, well, I guess Dorner did have a point. Perhaps he is good. And yeah, you know, go Dorner, kill more cops. Yeah, let's just randomly kill cops. I mean, you're light years worse than these police. And it just shows a society absolutely falling apart. Absolutely falling apart. Killing the police isn't going to do anything but get a civil war going. Most police are good men and women. Most departments are revenue generating. They don't know they're designed to ruin the economy. They don't know why people hate them because they don't have the money to pay these tickets. I mean, I was talking to one of my crew. He was up there dealing with a ticket, and he saw poor families and stuff, you know, $2,000-$3,000 stuff on tickets and things now. They've jacked up in Texas. And the people will turn around and cry because that's the grocery money, folks. I mean, this country's in a depression, and they're just squeezing. And so even, quote, good cops have an evil job now because the government's evil. You have an evil mission. I don't care what propaganda you put on it. But they're not individually evil. And we want to avoid the civil war. If, you know, they start coming for people and stuff, it's the gloves are off. And it's going to be a million times, I mean, way more than a million times Dorner. That's why the system is going to stage stuff to get the psychological war won, to blame anyone that resists as terrorist. But the system should look. The public hates you so much, they're wanting the public to kill your children. I mean, and that's why I don't want a revolution. A lot of times revolutions create something worse than what you had. I want the republic back. I want due process back. I want honorable behavior back. I want to put this monster back in the cage, okay? Believe me, I got a family. I've studied history. I'm getting chills right now. This country's on the edge of a powder keg. And the government's gearing up for checkpoints, martial law, you know, to crush the resistance once it starts. They're going to start the resistance, you idiots out there in law enforcement. Maybe you're not as naive as the public, but you still don't get the trap you're being set up for. Let's go out to break with my prediction. I'm not going to play the whole thing, but where I play the Wolf Blitzer and the rest of it. Let's go ahead and go to the clip that's up at Infowars.com. Here it is, 2 hours before they torched him.
The Chris Dorner Fiat. Wars.com news alert. We were just in here watching CNN. They claim that they've cornered him in some house. There's been some type of shootout in Big Bear, California, up in the snow-capped mountains. The issue here, though, is that now CNN especially refuses to show live footage and is just telling us what they're seeing from the helicopter. In the past, this was never done except for situations like Waco, where they ordered the news cameras back and then the place blew up in flames. He's reportedly got several hostages inside there. What the police tend to do and the military tends to do in a situation like this where they lost some of their own, they don't care about 17 little children under the age of 10 in the Waco compound. They blew it up and burned it to the ground. And I hope that doesn't happen here. But regardless, this is why people don't believe official stories. It's because over and over again, we're going to play the clip in a moment, the establishment media is caught lying about things, spinning things, and then not letting us see what's really happening. A few weeks ago at a shooting in Houston at a community college, they cut the feed. And we're saying different things than what we were watching on local Texas television with live feeds. They kept showing the scariest footage over and over again. They also do that to control the narrative and what's put out. But here's the bottom line. We have our guns because of government people like the alleged killer Chris Dorner that go crazy. When the government has all the guns, there's tyranny. When the people have the guns, there is liberty. When the government fears the people, there is liberty. When the people fear the government, there is tyranny. That's Thomas Jefferson. It's common sense. But let's go ahead and show you this clip. And again, they're still saying earlier.
Commissioner, it's Wolf Blitzer. We're watching what's going on here in the Situation Room as well. We are now showing our viewers videotape of the aerial area after law enforcement asked us no longer to show live pictures because that would help this suspect in this particular case potentially escape. So what our viewers now are seeing is videotape. We're no longer going to show the live pictures.
We got to go to break. And I go on to finish the clip, and Blitzer, of course, talked about this is unprecedented, well, except for Waco and places, and I say that's when they're usually going to torch something. So there's the prediction. The full video is up at Infowars.com. Your calls are straight ahead. Then the State of the Union breakdown, scariest ever.
Okay, so... What can you say? The Federal Bureau of Incineration textbook has been well read. We're going to go ahead and open up the phone lines now and see if we have any comments from the general public watching this show. I've been cruising through the listings on YouTube and Google, and there are hundreds of videos now coming out about this. You'll see all kinds of points of view that you haven't seen before. You'll see information that you haven't seen before. This is, you know, somebody just tuning in will say, well, hey, isn't this supposed to be 9/11 was an inside job? Yes, and state crimes against democracy. This is just a perfect example of the state going crazy. I'm almost speechless. You know, how many times do we have to see this type of death and carnage and then listen to their lies afterwards? I'm just sick and tired of hearing their lies. Okay, well, we got a call, so let's go ahead and take the call before I break down or do something else crazy. Go ahead, caller.
Hi, this is Cresson from Portland. I just wanted to call in and comment that this is absolutely unbelievable what happened at Big Bear. And, you know, people turning a blind eye really is only perpetuating the slumber that, you know, a country has fallen into. And there's a really great unrest growing among the you know, the young people. And we've seen the Occupy movements, seen the things that are happening in the urban areas. But, you know, there's an urban Occupy movement that's growing this moment, especially in Portland, and it's really growing to be a strong factor, and it's going to be, I would say, public in the next 4 to 6 weeks. But, everybody individually needs to wake up. but some kind of effective resistance point. We're all under attack, and it's going to come to a head for us all at the exact same moment.
Yeah, so, like this says right here, resistance is victory.
And what do we do now?
Yeah.
Exactly. So I'm just calling to encourage the viewers that might be watching or looking through channels to really take an active role in saving our country, saving our nation from where it's headed, because we all have an equal stake in it.
Well, thanks, caller. What did you think about the fact that, unlike the other big news events that we've had with the shootings and stuff that just kind of dragged on and on and on for weeks, with everybody talking about it for weeks, this all of a sudden, boom, nobody's talking about it, nobody's even mentioned it on the news. You notice there's a big difference there. It's pretty easy to tell. Well, anyway. You still there? I guess he left. Okay, we'll take the next caller. But as I was just saying, it is easy to tell the difference between the false flag ops and the ones that just get away from them. And sometimes the ones that get away from them tell us a lot more about what's going on. Is there a caller?
Yeah, hi there.
Go ahead.
Okay, yeah. I was listening to your program, and I just wanted to point out that I've got an awful lot of information that I've come across on Facebook. But just let's say... I was driving around in my car, listening to OPB during this stakeout, and I was listening to a police sergeant or somebody high up that did negotiations talking about it, and they had a very militaristic viewpoint here, and they had it all figured out. If you do this, they do this. Well, they pretty much knew exactly where all of this was going to end up, and this was just listening to the radio on from NPR or OPB. But anyway, I found a couple links, scanners, and I think that you showed some of those things from the Alex Jones show. And so if anybody wants to go to YouTube, they're going to find, if they just type in the scanner radio of the Dorner situation, you're going to be able to. But anyway, there was an ex-cop down there that wrote a book about all the racism problems down in the LAPD, and he was he definitely can understand the situation that Mr. Dorner was in, or Christopher Dorner was in, but this was not something that he would take to that reputation. He also mentioned that there were somewhere other people that had the same kind of manifesto as Christopher Dorner, but they committed suicide. But anyway, he wrote a book describing that, and after he read that book, he was fired, and then he was given the shaft and persecuted. Anyway, his book is called One Time, the Story of a South Central Los Angeles Police Officer. So I recommend anybody out there listening to this that wants to get a little bit more insight into just what goes on other than the local news, and you don't even really have to follow Alex Jones so much, but there's an awful lot of information out there, and I read this article on this one wire about Brian Bentley, who wrote a book. He describes his history, how he got involved with the police department. He had worked for a bank, he was a loan officer, and he said they got robbed so many times he wanted to join the police officers. So, and at that time, they were hiring people with some education to join the force down in LAPD. Anyway, I don't want to go on and on about what I've read about, because I did not live there. I'm just relating things that I read online.
Those are good points of interest to check out.
Yeah. So right anyway, I hope you go on with your show and keep on producing all of this information that's real helpful for people out there to get another viewpoint. We need to look at all these different sources. So
right on. Thank you.
All right. Take care. Bye.
Thank you. And there's no way that I can cover it all, and I don't even do a good job of covering what I do cover. But if you look at it from the point of view of I'm introducing people that may never have even heard of any of this stuff to the ideas that you've heard me show lately. We've got another call. Hey, if you guys would put my computer behind me, I'm going to scroll down and look at stuff on screen, too. So go ahead, caller. Go ahead, caller. Hello, caller.
Hello?
Oh, there we go. We got you now. If you have your TV set on in the background, please turn down the audio. Okay, anyway, what I'm showing while the caller...
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, hey, I just want to say don't take the vaccine, man.
Yeah, no kidding. Remember, did you happen to see that Piers Morgan, the guy that Alex Jones had argued with on CNN, he had taken a flu vaccine and immediately caught a really bad version of the flu?
Oh, yeah, he got well just the next day, didn't he?
No, yeah. Yeah,
yeah,
right. Yeah,
hey, well, thanks. Yeah, so I was in New York just the other day, and I was looking at Building 7, man, and just the news just looked at it again, then it was gone.
Yeah.
Where'd it go? What happened to Building number 7?
Yeah, that's the smoking gun of 9/11. But let me get back to this Dorner thing.
Hey, one more quick thing here.
Did you
know that in the continental United States we have more foreign troops now than domestic troops?
Oh, man, that's really sobering. And the reason they're doing that is because the domestic troops might not fire on Americans when they are ordered to.
Well, they're sent to all these nations out of our continental United States to never come back. We don't want them here. The hammer's coming down, baby, and I'm glad you're out there letting people know.
We'll see what happens, but all we can do is keep on trying.
Well, yeah. What can you do about bringing Alex to town? Maybe you can have Alex on as a guest.
Alex Jones,
or that's Alex? Right.
There's Alex Ansari too. He's an old timer. He's coming back. He's a mini Alex Jones. But anyway, yeah, Alex is so big time, he probably won't do that, but he's been very gracious at letting me use his videos and things. He's got no problem sharing his information.
All right, well, resistance is victory.
That's right, like it says right here. Okay, thanks a lot, caller. And
folks,
what you see behind me here, I've got the YouTube displayed that I was just searching. I just put in the word Dorner, the guy's last name. We'll take the next call, too. But there's some headlines. Christopher Dorner allegedly took his own life in standoff. That's ABC News. Here's one that says, official Christopher Rambo Dorner story. Chris Dorner was executed. Fire set by police. LAPD pulls a Waco on Dorner. Chris Dorner goes out Waco style. Standoff. Dorner surrounded by police. Anonymous. Operation Dorner. CNN interviews Chris Dorner. These are all headlines. I mean, you can go out and check this out, folks. What I've shown you today just should wake you up. And go ahead, caller. We got about 10 minutes left, so let's make hay while the sun shines. Go ahead, caller.
Am I in here?
Yes, you're on. You're live on Channel 11.
I am?
Yes, you are.
Oh, wonderful.
What have you got
hello?
To say?
I've watched you for a long time. And actually, I don't have any questions about 9/11 or about the LA cops. But I do have a question about what happened during Portland, Oregon with Mohammed and the alleged FBI, entrapment case.
That's a really good point, because here this guy is obviously a patsy, incapable of doing anything without the FBI's help. And you're right, you know, the FBI comes in to give him the explosives, they give him the plot, they arrange it, they tell him how to do it, they drive him to it, I mean, drive him to the site, whatever they did. I guess the main thing that he did that showed that he really was, you know, a terrorist was he went to Radio Shack and bought a toggle switch for them. But yeah, I don't know what the results were. He got convicted, and I'd love to hear, you know, the defending lawyer's analysis of what, you know, went on. That'll probably be a good one.
Yes, I would too.
Yeah, I'll try to look that up for next time, because that was an example real close to home of the, you know, fraudulent FBI, you know, rescuing us from some terrorist plot. They're always FBI plots that they're rescuing
us
from.
Well, didn't that get close to 9/11? Something about 9/11?
What about it?
Didn't that get close to some kind of FBI involvement with 9/11?
Well, yeah. I mean, remember on the last show or two, I was talking about the 1993 Trade Center bombing where the fellow who was supposed to be the mastermind was actually a paid provocateur, paid for by the FBI, and he was smart enough to record his conversations. So when he went to court, he said, wait a minute, that's not what really happened. I have recordings here.
But yes, I did hear you that. I did hear that loud and clear.
Yeah, and so that was a really good example of you know, them getting caught with their pants down. They didn't realize that they had been recorded, and so their story wasn't accepted blindly like usual. It's just insane. Well, what do you think about the news being cut off on this Dorner thing, though, the Chris Dorner? I mean, all of a sudden, I mean, they built up a crescendo. It was on the news every which way, talking about all the people that were afraid, all the people that were getting shot and all that. And then all of a sudden, a blackout. Well, anyway, thanks, caller. We got another caller on the line, so we're going to go to the next caller. Next caller.
Newton, can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I hear you just fine. Go ahead.
Okay. I just want to point out the unprofessionalism of these police. The way I hear it sounds like a truck's driving by. Can you hear me okay now?
Oh, yeah, I hear you just fine.
Okay. There was a bunch of noise on you coming from your end. Oh. Anyway, I just want to point out the unprofessionalism of these police officers.
I hear you.
Profanity is used over the airwaves. I spent 35 years as a firefighter. And
if you have
anybody use any kind of profanity over the air, which I never heard anybody doing, but they just knew ahead of time, if you used any kind of profanity over the air, probably lose at least one pay period. You know, you'd be
suspended
for at least half a month. You know?
That's
so to show you that these people aren't really professionals, they're just jackasses, you know, that are still in the grade.
I understand.
Anyway, sir, well, hey, thanks for all the extra work you do and keeping us informed, and take care, and we're all supporting you out here.
You bet. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. And I'd like to take this moment to say that, you know, people always say, what can I do? And the answer is, you know, pick something that interests you and just do it. You know, it doesn't have to, you can't do everything. I've already found out I can't do everything. I couldn't begin to cover these news things, and other people do it so much better than I do anyway. So I've kind of found a niche for myself where I'm basically nothing more than a video jockey. I kind of show you other people's work, but I don't have to reinvent the wheel that way, and I do make sure that some things that people don't hear about, you know, maybe get spread around where others could hear it. And we got another caller, so let's take that caller. We got 5 minutes left.
Yeah, hello, how you doing?
Just fine. How are you? Go ahead. What have you got to say?
Yes, people have to remember about the Dorner was, why they went after Dorner was, he was a whistleblower. And look what they did to him when he blew his whistle.
That's right.
They convicted him.
That's exactly right. You know, there are a lot of people that don't like whistleblowers, and almost all of them are the ones that are being blown about.
Yeah, that's true. But if you're going to become a whistleblower, the most important thing to remember is when you go in to report it, to ask for immunity from prosecution, full immunity from prosecution.
Right.
And then they won't come after you.
But they also won't give it to you.
That's what I mean true.
But then you say, okay, well, then I won't be a whistleblower right now. Thank you very much.
Yeah, but I mean, a whistleblower, I mean, usually they'll accept that. You have to go in with an attorney when you blow the whistle and say, hey, I want full immunity from prosecution. Because look what happened to the, remember back in 2004, the prison in Iraq?
Oh, Abu Ghraib?
Yeah, when the person who took the pictures got so upset, he turned the pictures in, but he didn't ask for immunity.
And he got prosecuted. I remember that.
Yeah, he got prosecuted. How many years did he get?
That's right. I don't know. He shouldn't have got any for that.
Yeah,
well,
but he did.
Yeah.
All I have to say is that this is a whistleblower case. And that's how the government wants to control whistleblowers.
It's amazing. And they even have these so-called whistleblower protection laws. And, of course, now the Obama administration is number one in prosecuting whistleblowers, prosecuting more whistleblowers than all other administrations combined. Yeah, and check out the Sibel Edmonds story that we covered pretty well. We played her 45-minute movie called Kill the Messenger. And that's a really good one if you want to go back and see how, you know, she went through every, she jumped through every hoop the way she was supposed to report the corruption in the FBI. And she wound up being termed the most classified woman in history. She wasn't even able to tell what her skills were. I mean, they put a gag on her. She couldn't even tell what her job was at the FBI. You know, what she did daily. It's amazing. But she persevered, and now she's moved to Oregon, to Bend. I'm going to have to find out. I know that she's in contact with James Corbett. I've played the Corbett Report videos here many times, and James Corbett's in contact with her an awful lot. Maybe I can contact her through him. I've tried other ways, and I don't seem to get any response. I'm probably just too small, too small a fish in the pond to worry about. But it doesn't matter. You just keep plugging along and keep putting out the information, and it's not about me or fame or anything like that. But you just keep doing what you can. And by the way, I've told people that you know, if they find my truck on the bridge, I didn't jump, I was pushed. You know, if any of that stuff happens, I have no fears myself. And somebody just brought it up, and I'm telling them, you know, hey, I love life too much. I'm not depressed about anything. And I'm pissed off about stuff, but there's a big difference between being pissed off and being depressed. So, okay, hey, we have about a minute and three quarters, and we got a call. We'll take that last call, and hopefully we have enough time for it.
Hello, Bill.
Go ahead.
Hello, real quick. Have you found out anything more about that video of whatever it was hitting the Pentagon?
Oh, no, I haven't found anything out about that at all, and I've been looking, too, and I don't see any more news about it. I kind of expected some of the, 9/11 groups to either debunk it or champion it. I don't know which.
Okay, man, right on. Have a good night. But
thank you. That was an interesting one, though. That I remember that we showed that where you could see it wasn't a plane for sure. It looked just like a missile, but was it a real video? How come we didn't see it before? Where was it filmed from? Who filmed it? And was it authentic? Well, we've got 1 minute. We're going to be playing the credits over it, but go ahead and try talking there. Oh, the caller's gone. Okay, well, again, look up on the internet the Chris Dorner debacle. You'll see all kinds of things like the tapes that we played were showing the cops that had just placed 7 burners, meaning those incendiary gas cartridges, set in and it's burning. And I did hear one where somebody replied good, but we didn't play that part on this. I don't know why it wasn't there, but anyway, we're going to sign off until next time. See you next the beginning of March, on the first Saturday in March.